हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ न्यूक्लियस एंड द स्ट्रक्चर विच इज़ एसोसिएटेड विद दिस, लाइक एंडोप्लाज्मिक रेटिकुलम एंड राइबोसोम्स. सो स्टूडेंट, यू कैन सी हियर, दिस इज़ अ स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ न्यूक्लियस एंड द आउटर मोस्ट कवरिंग इज न्यूक्लियर मेम्ब्रेन और विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज न्यूक्लियर एनवेलप विच इज़ एबसेंट इन प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल. Then nuclear pore, nucleolus, and the fluid which is present in this, it is nucleoplasm. And this structure, this thread-like interwined structure is known as chromatin fibers. Chromatin fibers. So this is the structure. I think you all well understand nuclear envelope, nuclear membrane, nucleoplasm, the fluid which is present, and this is the double membrane structure. And you can see here some convoluted, some you can say tubules like structure is present, and this is called as endoplasmic reticulum. And here you can see some granular structures are also present on them, and this is called as ribosomes. Ribosomes which are present on ER. In short, for endoplasmic reticulum, we use the term ER. So, students, see, you can see another structure here. This is the connection of nuclear envelope with endoplasmic reticulum. You can see how it is get connected through outer membrane. This is a pore in the membrane which is known as nuclear pore. So first thing, nature and occurrence. Where it is found? So nucleus is large, centrally located. And this is also called brain of the cell because all the activities is being controlled by this nucleus. That's why it is also called as the brain of the cell. So nucleus is large, centrally located, and spherical. You can see this is spherical cellular component. It is bounded by two nuclear membranes, and these outer and inner membrane, outer and inner membrane forms a nuclear envelope. And this nuclear envelope encloses a space between two nuclear membrane and is connected to a system of membranes called the ER. As I show in the diagram, that the outer, see here, this is connected by the membrane and this is called ER. The nuclear envelope separate the nucleus from the cytoplasm. As in last lecture, I told you that what is the cytoplasm. So I just make one, you can say, equation, that is protoplasm minus nucleus is called as cytoplasm. So the part of the cell which occurs between the plasma membrane and nuclear envelope, better you call it as nuclear envelope. It is called cytoplasm. So you got it, the part of the cell which occurs between plasma membrane and the nuclear envelope, it is called the cytoplasm. So once you just delete nuclear content from the protoplasm, whatever the left is cytoplasm, and the soluble part of the cytoplasm is called as cytosol. So clear. So the nuclear envelope, it separates the nucleus from the cytoplasm, and the nuclear envelope contain many pores, which is known as nuclear pore, as I shown you, and it encloses the liquid ground substance, which is called nucleoplasm. And nucleopore, what is the function of nucleopores? It allows transfer of materials. See here, it allows transfer of material between the nucleoplasm and the cytoplasm. So it is a connecting link to transfer the material. Within nucleoplasm, two types of nuclear structure are embedded. This is the nucleolus and the this cytoplasm. Within nucleoplasm, see, it's not cytoplasm, it's a nucleolus. There are two structure which is enclosed by the nuclear envelope, and this is called nucleolus and the chromatin fibers. So don't get confused with cytoplasm. Only nucleolus and chromatin fibers, and here the fluid which is present, it is called nucleoplasm. And nuclear envelope separates other liquid, that is cytoplasm, from the cell. So this is a nucleolus which synthesize RNA. Nucleolus may be one or more in number and is bounded by not bounded by any membrane. There is no membrane. So it is rich in protein and RNA. Molecules and act as the site of ribosome formation. So nucleolus act as the site of ribosome formation. This is also called as factory of ribosomes. Nucleolus is also called as factory of ribosomes. So this is all about the nucleus structure, and the last one is the chromatin material or chromatin fiber. Chromatin material or chromatin fiber, it is a thin thread like interwined means aapas mein uljha hua interwined mass of chromosome material, and composed of the genetic substance which is called as DNA and proteins. And basically the proteins which is present here, DNA plus histone protein, you will learn about this in class 11th, what is the meaning of histone protein. Here you can see that the DNA is always associated with some protein, and that type of protein is known as histone proteins. Basically chromatin is formed of repeating subunit, and this is called as nucleosome. DNA stores all the information which is necessary for the cell to function, to grow and to reproduce. What are the function? Cell to function, it means for metabolic function, to grow and to reproduce. Further cell to the next generation, means it carries the information from one generation to another generation. And distinct segments of DNA are called genes, or better you called as the functional part of DNA which has been transferred from one generation to another generation. It is called genes, or In other way round, you can say that the distinct segment of DNA are called genes, or functional segment of DNA are called genes, which has been transferred from one generation to another generation. So the chromatid is condensed into two or more thick ribbon-like structure, and that is called as chromosome during the division of cell. You can say once the cell is going to divide, the structure become like this. You can see here this structure. This chromosome is during cell division. So see the structure. This is the centrosome. These are the two arms of chromosome. This is unreplicated chromosome, means it is going to be replicated. And duplicated chromosome or replicated chromosome, you can see it form 1 to 2, and this is called as sister chromatids. And this is the sister chromatids, and it forms the daughter chromosome. Daughter means not daughter exactly, daughter means new chromosome. Daughter always meant for new chromosome. Do not go for the gender that it is female. It is always a new chromosome. This is also called as daughter chromosome. So chromosome are thread like structure usually present in the nucleus that become visible only during cell division. Point to be remember, it always remain like this, but once a cell is going to divide, you can see the structure of chromosome. So it visible only during cell division, whether the cell divided by the meiosis or mitosis. These two terms I will explain you further what is the meaning of mitosis and meiosis. And chromosome contain hereditary information of the cell in the form of genes, as I told you. These are also, genes are also called as hereditary unit. And each chromosome is made up of two components, DNA and proteins. So DNA, that is deoxyribose nucleic acid, and proteins, histones and acidic proteins. Histones mostly contain basic protein. As DNA is acidic in nature, so it has to be bound by the some basic protein, and histone has so many of basic proteins. So this is the structure about nucleus, nuclear membrane and the chromosome.